How's everyone doing? I feel bad. I've been wanting to make videos. I have ideas happily, more and more, but time and energy are still a distance from me. But I'm on the upswing after knowing what I'm being was diagnosed fibromyalgia, and I've cut out gluten, and I've been able to cut out a lot of things, like too many supplements. I cut out coffee. I'm just being really careful and mindful and listening to my body, but I'm getting better and I'm excited, so hopefully I'll make more videos. But because it's June and before June is over, and June is Pride Month, I really wanted to talk about identity because I was somewhat triggered by a post that I saw on Facebook. And it said something about, I wish I could remember it all, but I've had a lot of other stuff going on in my life. But this is a topic I can't seem to let go of, so I want to talk about it. It was a meme talking about trans being trans. And let me preface everything I'm about to say with saying that this is all coming from my limited perspective, and I make these videos to have a healthy dialogue with people so that I can learn something too. I think healthy dialogue is important because we all have different life experiences, and I think respecting one another is important. So when I speak, I'm speaking from heteroromantic, binary, white, female, sexually fluid perspective. That being said, this was a comment about needing acknowledgement as a trans person. I don't remember the meme exactly, and I apologize. I really wish that I did. But what struck me was not the meme, it was a comment I saw by a white male, I would assume who's binary. By all intents and purposes, looking at his profile, he looked like he was a hetero binary male. But his comment was something to the effect of, "We don't care. Like, no one really cares." In other words, I'm going to not to play devil's advocate. I'm not justifying anything. I'm trying to offer some perspective to people who need other people to hear them, because I know what it's like to not be heard for my own reasons. I could understand to some degree, because I'm also looking at my former self, things in my own ignorance, things I may have thought or said even out loud. I've said and done a lot of stupid things in my own ignorance. Ignorance is bliss, though, right? Until you realize that it takes someone's bliss away from them, and then it's not so blissful. That hits me in the feels. That's interesting. You just notice things like that within yourself. It's important. But I remember having the same thought, and that's why it probably stuck with me. Why do I care? Like, why do you need me to know that you're trans? Or why do you need me to know that you're gay or whatever? Because I don't feel the need to tell other people that about myself. And then I realized that's my privilege speaking. After getting to know different people who are trans and falling in love with them in a platonic way, I fall in love with people all day, every day. There's a lot of different types of love, right? But I fall deeply in love with people so easily. And it's 99.9% of the time platonic. But then I started to reflect on all the times my identity was taken from me. And it may not have been because of my sexuality, because I'm a very what you see is what you get person. Although a lot of trans people and gay people are also, right? You kind of know what's going on with them just by looking at them because everybody has their own aesthetic, they have their own way of mannerism, stuff like that. But that was never a question for me, and I never felt like announcing it, but that's because my way of being is socially acceptable. And there are other ways of my being, though, that have not been accepted. In fact, I had to reflect on the fact that I had to struggle to learn what my identity even was. And it might not have been around my gender or around my sexuality or around what I want out of life and relationships in relationship setting, but it was around who I was at my core. And it's not even that I had forgotten, unless we're talking about lifetimes, then yes, I'm sure I've forgotten who I am over lifetimes, if that is indeed a thing. And it's weird, I'm looking at this solo white cloud that's glowing in the sky behind me. It's really cool. So I keep getting distracted by that. I'm a dreamer. But I grew up in a very strict religion that told you who you had to be, how you had to behave. And I went from that as a child, virtually. I was just turning 19 and he was just turning 18. Neither of us knew who we were, what we wanted, much less one another. We had ideas. I had an idea of what marriage, I had a fantasy of what marriage was supposed to be like. And he likely had an idea. I can't completely speak for him because that's not fair, because we've made our peace with one another, which is beautiful. But he likely had an idea of what and who I should be. Almost like I was a doll that he wanted to dress up, which I hated until I started doing it to another man later in life. And projecting my ideal, my romantic ideal, onto someone who would never live up to that. It's funny how things come full circle, right? So I had to struggle once I got out of abusive relationships and a religion that forced me into that with its own brainwashing and constant perpetual inundation of fear-mongering and control, and then a relationship where the only thing that we both knew was perpetuating that control. And then once you escape that and somebody telling you what your identity is supposed to be, you have to figure out with no blueprint what your identity is. And then once you start to figure it out, you put it out there, right? I have put out there that I'm an INFJ. I'm an Aries sun, Taurus moon, Pisces rising. My life path number is an 11. I was born a young rabbit, young earth element in a wood rabbit year. I mean, that was my love language, is figuring out my identity. And when you have known trauma that has taken your identity, any kind of abuse, emotional, mental, physical, any kind of manipulation, gaslighting, you name it, the list can go on and on, but anything that traumatizes you to question or shame who you are and your identity. And yes, spiritualists will say being attached to your identity is a form of low vibration. And you need to learn to accept that identity is also a fluid thing. As we learn and grow and evolve as individual humans, and then as also collective humans, our identity will shift. And if we get too attached to an identity, then it is a spiritual failing, essentially, because we can't learn and grow and evolve beyond that. And to me, if we're talking about spirituality, I'm going to segue just a moment to the fact that, spiritually speaking, absolute spiritual embodiment of divinity is the embracing of the divine masculine and the divine feminine in all living things, right? From plants to animals to human beings. And how much more elegant is that than trans people? And I saw a TikTok the other day. I would definitely look it up, search it, about two-spirited people, because indigenous people, different tribes believed in five genders, and there would be a two-spirited male and two-spirited female, and they had different genders. But If you've ever known people who have those two spirits within them, like they might identify to the world as one gender, as a female, but they feel that masculine in them also. And then I studied in sociology about how that's actually possible. And the more trans people are, the more they're seeing and feeling like their anatomical parts of their body might not match their DNA or their chromosome makeup. It's fascinating science, and not enough of it is being done, so people don't understand it. So what happens? We all fight to have our identities shared. And then as someone whose identity is socially acceptable, especially a privileged white male who's never had to worry about his identity being taken from him, the most he might know is, and I'm speculating here, but I've known men that the most of their identity that's ever been taken from them is getting fired from a job they really identified with. I mean, that's a trauma. I mean, I'm not downplaying how significant of a trauma that is. I'm just saying that if you could take that and magnify it by the core of who you are, the very essence of who you are, which is ultimately, spiritually speaking, actually an embracing and a physical embodiment of divinity, when you can have, because we all have both energetic genders within us, because energy, the masculine and feminine energy, we have both that flowing within us, just like electricity needs positive and negative. We have positive and negative neurons. I mean, it all is part of what makes us alive. And some people, it just shows up in a very clear way physically than it does other people. And why not claim that? Why not claim that uniqueness? Why can't they? If you want to claim that you have this job and you identify with that, or, you know, I've gone through these traumas and I feel like it taught me a lot about something and that has helped shape who I am and what I have to offer the world, why can't I claim that? And do other people care? No, a lot of people don't care. But there's something about healing trauma and healing abuse, claiming your identity and spreading it out into the world as a form of self-love. Kind of like when you fall in love with someone and you want to scream at the mountaintops. There's always that expression, right? I want to cry from the mountaintops, my love for you. I want to proclaim it. And at some point, when you learn to stop shaming yourself and you learn to accept and love who you are, you want to cry it from the mountaintops. And it also helps inadvertently give other people the courage to love and claim who they are. Does that come with shadow aspects and negatives? Of course it does. And does everybody care? No. But that's not really why we do it, right? Usually we're doing it for our own healing and for our own sake. And some people who can relate will support us and say, good for you, I'm excited for you. And the people that it doesn't really resonate with, that it doesn't matter to them, that's okay too. But you can just keep scrolling, you know? You can just keep walking. You don't have to acknowledge it. Like, there's no point in saying, no one cares. It's like, well, clearly you care, or you wouldn't have put in the effort and the energy to make a comment saying that you don't care. Because to me, what that's saying is something deep inside of you actually does care. It does matter, and it triggered you somehow, because maybe part of your identity isn't being acknowledged. And somebody shared this thought of someone else that's completely unrelated to you, or maybe it's extremely related to you and you're hiding it, who knows? But hiding it from yourself more than anyone else. And it triggered you enough to evoke a response. And that's the key, right? If something triggers us enough to evoke a response, then that is a reflection of us, not the thing that triggered us, right? That's an invitation to look within. So when I first saw that guy's comment, and my first thought was, I've had that thought before. And then I had to stop and reflect and say, wow, I've had that thought before. And how many times have I need my identity acknowledged by someone? How many times am I needy and just need my partner to acknowledge me somehow or acknowledge something I've done because I've spent my entire life not being recognized or acknowledged for who I am? And now that I have a partner who just accepts me and loves me for who I am, and it's so easy and it's so natural that clearly something must be wrong, so I have to have it validated because it's so unfamiliar to me. And then you will just look at me like, it's amazing, like, duh, what's wrong with you? And I'm like, I don't understand how this is so easy. Is there something wrong? So yeah, I guess the moral of the story is, and I might talk about identity and other things too. I've had thoughts about why we feel sorry for people who we see as less than us, whether it's a handicap or they're going through a specific struggle, when really we have our own things that we're dealing with. Is it a way of elevating ourselves? Is it a way of being grateful? I don't know. Is it a combination of those things? I just find these things interesting. These are things I think about a lot. And I haven't had the energy between working full time and dealing with healing my fibromyalgia. I haven't had the energy to write and to make videos. I've had to put my health first, and it's working. So I'm not sorry about that. I'm on an upswing and I'm really excited. So I appreciate your patience. If you've watched this whole thing, I'm extremely grateful, and I would love to hear any thoughts you have on why we need our identities before we can even release them in spiritual growth. We have to realize what we identify with, because it helps us form our little subcultures, right? It helps us find our people, our tribes, our communities. Identity does help us do that. I think there's a healthy form of identity, just like there's a healthy ego. Our healthy ego keeps us safe. It helps us, again, find our tribe, find our communities. Unhealthy ego gets overly identified with things that could potentially hold us back or keep us stuck in a victim mentality or suffering, because we can get addicted to our own suffering. We can also get addicted to process. You can get addicted to feeling the need to continually heal or talk about your healing. And triggers will bring things up, but it's important to look at what's being brought up and releasing it instead of getting too enmeshed in whatever's coming up. It's a tricky balance. But I'd love to hear thoughts. Again, please share them. I'm sorry this is so long, but I haven't shared a video in a long time, and this is a topic that's really important to me, and I would like to discuss it more because I want to know better so that I can do better and be better. And if you are up there with me in that thought process, I invite your comments and questions. If you don't care about any of this or you think it's trite, then I invite you to move along and find something that you are passionate about, because there's no need to waste your energy on something that you don't think is important, right? So don't bother yourself with it. That's your invitation to just move right on. Mwah! I love you all for watching. I appreciate you for sticking with me. And hopefully this is the beginning of more videos. I hope.